Hey everyone, if you're using Datadog for logs or APM, you've already got visibility into what's happening inside your backend. But here's the real question. Do you know what your users are seeing right now? Your backend traces might look perfect, but your users could be stuck on a blank screen, waiting on a slow script, or clicking a broken button. That's exactly where Real User Monitoring, or RUM, comes in. RUM is Datadog's window into what real users experience, right in their browsers or mobile apps. No fake traffic, no simulations, just real data. Every click, every page load, every error, exactly as it happens. Think of it like a telescope for your user experience. It doesn't just tell you something broke, it reveals who was affected, where and why. Before going further, quick note, we are rebranding from Dataiker to Digitam. So if you want to test our governance app for Datadog, go to app.digitam.io. To really understand RUM, there are five key concepts. Once these click, everything else falls into place. Let's break them down. Sessions, the complete journey of a user over time. Views, each page or route they visit. Actions, what users do, clicks, scrolls, form submissions, custom events. Resources, what the app loads, APIs, images, scripts. Errors, JavaScript exceptions, failed requests, or front-end crashes. If that feels abstract, think of RUM as a movie. The session is the full film. Each view is a scene. Actions are what your characters do. Resources are the props. And errors. Those are the bloopers when something goes wrong on set. RUM records it all, so you can replay, filter, and analyze every moment. Let's jump into Datadog and see this in action. Here's the RUM Explorer, a familiar layout with filters and facets right at the top. You'll find filters for environment, country, browser, and version. These are your facets. Open any session, and you'll see all its views laid out chronologically. Each view expands into a detailed timeline, showing user actions, loaded resources, and any related errors. First, let's navigate to RUM Digital Experience under Real User Monitoring. Here, you'll get an overview of all your sessions across applications. From the app selector, just choose the specific application you want to analyze, and we're ready to dive in. Here you can see performance data for all your applications. We'll explore that in a moment, but first let's open the Explorer, where you can view all currently active sessions in real time. If I filter for the past 2 weeks, you'll see all recorded sessions in that period. At the top, you'll find key metrics: sessions, views, actions, errors, resources, load time, and long tasks. All neatly organized for quick insight. Facets are one of the most powerful tools in RUM and across Datadog as a whole. They let you slice your data any way you want, by user, browser, version, region, or even custom attributes. For example, you can filter by user.email to follow a specific user journey, or by service frontend to isolate frontend-only sessions. It's how thousands of data points become clear, actionable context. On the left side, you'll see what makes Datadog so powerful. Instant filtering. Want to view only mobile sessions? Click mobile. Prefer desktop? Click desktop. And it goes further. You can filter by specific user attributes. For instance, enter a user's email to find all their sessions. Click one, and Datadog automatically filters the data for that individual journey. Now I can clear or adjust filters and keep exploring. Notice that I've been searching at the session level, but I could also switch to the view level for a different perspective. At the view level, I can see details like the specific view names, giving me a finer breakdown of user interactions. Let's say I want to see how many users visited the ownership observability view. Here I can see two matching sessions. From there, I can dig deeper into user actions or errors within those sessions. And if I remove the filters, I can expand back out to review all the errors across the app, helping me quickly spot recurring issues. The best part? You don't need to learn any query language. Everything you need is right there on the left side. And even if you're not sure which level to search, view, session, or otherwise, Datadog intelligently guides you to the right context. RUM also creates seamless connections between views and sessions. You can start your search at the session level, then jump directly into a specific view to understand exactly what the user saw. When you enable RUM, Datadog automatically generates a default dashboard. It includes metrics like active users and sessions, views over time, errors per view, slowest pages, and top impacted users or browsers. It's your instant high-level health check for front-end performance, right out of the box. In other words, RUM gives you ready-to-use dashboards out of the box. You can view them at any level, from summary performance to front-end vitals, errors, deployments, and resources. At the top, you'll find template variables to switch between environments like production or development, or filter by related services for deeper insights. You can also browse out-of-the-box dashboards directly from the dashboard list. Under Integrations, RUM, you'll find several pre-built dashboards that help you explore how your application is performing across different dimensions. For example, if I want to analyze performance, I can open the performance dashboard, select a one-week view, and use the template filters at the top. From here, I can explore Core Web Vitals, see how they're trending, and start investigating any dips or slowdowns in performance. So if the default dashboards are not enough, this gives me a good place to create my own and explore in depth what could be wrong. If I notice a high error rate, I can switch to the error dashboard for a closer look. These dashboards automatically surface the most relevant metrics, so you don't need to dig manually, though understanding the fundamentals always helps you get more out of them. All the components and data sources behind these metrics are already integrated. Everything you see here is available out of the box, ready to use from day one. So, how do you know when users are getting frustrated? Datadog automatically detects frustration signals, including rage clicks when users click the same element repeatedly, dead clicks, clicks that don't trigger any response, and error clicks, clicks on an element right before a JavaScript error occurs. These signals help you spot where real users are losing patience. Let's jump back into the Explorer and check the frustration count. If we filter for any count above one, we can instantly see where users encountered friction. Click on any of these sessions to investigate what happened. And just like other data, you can graph frustration metrics in a dashboard for ongoing monitoring and trend analysis. Here we can see the event was a click, perhaps one that triggered too late or didn't respond at all. By drilling down, we can pinpoint exactly what caused the frustration. The goal is simple: identify and eliminate anything that could frustrate your users. Next, let's talk about Core Web Vitals, Google's key web performance standards. Here are the main three. LCP, largest contentful paint, measures how quickly the main content loads. FID, first input delay, tracks how fast your app responds to user input. CLS, cumulative layout shift, gauges how visually stable your layout is. Datadog RUM automatically tracks all three. You can filter by them, create widgets, and even correlate poor vitals with specific browsers or regions. To explore your Core Web Vitals in detail, head to Performance Monitoring, Summary. From there, select the application you're interested in, say Tiger or Blog. You'll find key metrics like largest contentful paint, first contentful paint, and cumulative layout shift, all neatly visualized for performance insights. Here, everything's in the green zone, great news. But it's always smart to check a longer time frame, like the past 2 weeks, to confirm that performance has stayed consistently strong. When you combine sessions, views, actions, and errors with frustration signals and Core Web Vitals, you unlock a complete 360 degrees view of your user experience. It's not just about what broke anymore, it's about who it affected, how often, and why. That context helps developers and product teams focus on the fixes that truly matter. As we've seen, everything in Datadog RUM is connected. You can jump from optimizations to other applications, or dive back into the Explorer to analyze patterns and performance. It's all interconnected, letting you drill down, zoom out, and understand exactly how your app behaves. Another powerful aspect is how Datadog unifies optimizations, performance metrics, and errors within the same platform. This connected view lets you understand high-level trends while still being able to investigate individual user sessions in depth. From any specific view, you can inspect all the related API calls, resources, and requests within your application. This makes it easy to jump to traces or logs, helping you troubleshoot issues faster and understand how your app behaves from both front-end and back-end perspectives. To wrap up, real user monitoring is your gateway to front-end observability. It connects real behavior, real performance, and real errors, so you can truly understand what your customers experience. In our next video, we'll take it one step further with Session Replay, where you can literally see what users saw and connect it back to your backend traces. And with this new series on RUM, as mentioned, we are rebranding name from Dataiker to Digitam. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, leave a comment or subscribe for more Datadog deep dives. And on that, happy monitoring.